All that alive. Oh, their first observer is out. Gonna head cross map. But here comes the Zerg army. Speed is on the way for those roaches. They are coming to check to see that if that third is there. But there's no third there quite yet.
Yeah, and Real really can't engage this just yet. He might barely come on top because the speed's not done, but he doesn't realize that just yet. And the force fields have to be perfect, so I really hope he doesn't engage us. The Nexus is going down, though. Will the force fields be good enough? Oh, Real being so greedy right now trying to bait that army. I don't know if he has enough to hold this off.
I mean, with Blink, I wouldn't be surprised if he holds it. And with that Immortal now joining the composition, he should be able to. And look at that. Death Angel knows he's pulling back with that army. He knows that he's kind of overstayed his welcome. Especially, I mean, having the Overlord killed off by that, the Spockers on the low ground, that's a dead tell, of course, that there is an Observer out on the map, which means Robotech is done. And you got to be so careful as the Zerg player as soon as there are Sentries plus Immortals on the field. It's such a deadly combination.
And we've had Death Angel droning up like a madman. He's back up to 68 drones. He's got 16 roaches on the way. Oh, he needs to be careful.
Oh, he's going to go ahead and engage. Pincers off a few of them, Zoya.
Yeah, he needs to be very careful right now. He needs to salvage every unit he can. Yep. He needs to keep alive because this push is looking very scary. There's no third base here. He doesn't know that, but there's no third base from Real. So with the no third, this is looking very all-in-ish. Real has to come up with a game plan soon. He's super supply blocked right now. He needs to do something soon, but there are a bunch of roaches here engaging this.
Oh.
If he can target fire it's so huge.
He gets one of them. He looks like he's going to get the other one, but the Stalker's doing a ton of damage as well. And the Immortal, it's so close to dead, but it stays alive. Another one joining the composition as well, so there's still two Immortals out on the field. And that's a good number of Immortals to have two out on the field. So the roaches have speed now. Burrow is on the way, plus two just now being started. But, I mean, pure roach versus, even within like 20 to 30 supply of Blink Stalker Sentry Immortal goes to the Blink Stalker Sentry Immortal. Like, the Protoss army wins that fight. But here's a counterattack going on from Death Angel trying to push in. He's going to be able to kill off that forge for sure. But at the same time, the Protoss ball waltzing into the third base, that will fall without a doubt.
Yeah, this is going to be an interesting base race here. Burrow is finished. If we look at that units tab, there is one Observer on the map, so we'll have to keep that in mind the entire game. We do have a nice defense up at this base, so he's going to be able to whittle down as much of this army as possible, but I don't think he got a single drone on the map, and that's going to be problematic because I don't know if he's going to be able to hold this at all. Drones being pulled, getting a huge round on these Stalkers. The main base is also under attack from Real. The supply is plummeting for Death Angel. Real's looking pretty stable right now. The Spine Callers are just barely about to finish. Will this be enough to hold, though?
Yeah, it's going to be interesting. I mean, there is that probe on the map, and he does actually have... Oh, no! He just spent all of his money. He had enough to make another Nexus. Real did, that is. But he just spent basically all of his money warping in a whole bunch of units. But he is pressing into the Zerg base there, and this might be, you know, the base trade of all ages going on right here.
The problem is that there's no drone on the map for Death Angel.
Yep.
He has enough units back home where he's going to try and get the base race, but there are three pylons here in the bottom right-hand corner of the map that he can now see. So if he can sneak a drone out, Death Angel might be able to win this, but I don't know if he's going to be able to do that. This is actually going to come down to the last building. Will he get the force field on the ramp? He's catching a lot of drones right now.
Oh, the drones are trying to sneak out. They are trying. Will they be able to? I don't think so. No, the Blink Ford. He's making a drone with one larva down at the natural base. But it's going to come, like you said, down to the last building. Look at that. The assimilator going down in the base of Death Angel. Real knows that all of his pylons are getting taken out by these roaches right now. And this is all he's going to have is this assimilator in his opponent's main.
The last building left is this Roach Warren. He has to get the hatchery down, and he does.
Problem
is, he doesn't realize the assimilator went up in that main base. He can't cancel this hatchery.
No, he can't. He doesn't have enough money.
Here
it comes.
It.
Yeah. He's going to lose the game right here. He sees the hatch. He knows it's going down. He can't, like you said, he can't cancel. Oh, no, there's an assimilator in the main. He could cancel the hatch. He does. Oh! But he can't. Did he cancel the hatch at the same time?
He canceled the hatch and tried to get it away.
No, but
the extractor
got
killed.
Oh, the extractor got killed.
Yeah.
Okay. I was like, "What just happened there?" That was actually insane.
That was interesting base race there. When you know you're going to be in that kind of situation, you should immediately evacuate one drone. Yep. That should be the first thing you do. If it doesn't end up being a base race where he goes home, then it's just like, oh, okay, I send that one drone back home. But when it does turn into that, and you don't have a single drone on the map, a situation like that happens, and it's rough. It's really rough. I mean, if we go back to when Death Angel engaged the base race by pushing at that main base, it would have been really hard to hold. The problem is that a lot of Zergs play too greedy and just don't throw down spine crawlers whenever they see something like this coming. They just try to hold with as many roaches as possible. And by the time the spines were done, it was too late, and you really can't come back from that. It was close, though. It came down to that one building.
Yep, it did. It certainly did. So those guys are tied up now, guys. We're going to go to a short break. When we get back, the next match between Real and Death Angel, it's tied up 1-1 right now, making it exciting, putting us behind schedule, but it's okay, because we got StarCraft coming up. I'm Gwen, with me is Zoya. Stay tuned, we'll be right back.
What map will he pick? Why? You can't stop me.
Alright guys, this is Gwen. I'm back with Zoya. Getting into that next game. It's going to be on Ohana, which, I mean, is the map choice out of our Zerg player, and I don't know about this choice.
Yeah,
it's I don't know. Past three bases.
You can get a fourth base as Zerg, but it's the fifth base that's the problem. It's the same map, a problem that the last map has for Zerg. It's hard to get that fifth.
It is. It's tough.
And he's got a comfortable style here. We'll have to see what his game plan is. Both players are ready.
Yep. So we're just waiting for our admin to get the game started for us. And then we'll be jumping in on Ohana. Guys, if you're watching on stream, please let us know. You know how audio is, how it looks, all that good stuff. If you have any lag issues, I'd love to know. And remember that if we get 500 people watching, we're giving out a keyboard from Azio. They actually took the keyboard with them to the Gigabyte Esports LAN, and they got all the pros to sign it. So it is super awesome looking. Super awesome looking.
It is.
You should check it out. I can pull it up on screen for just a little bit before we jump into the game. And I think I did the scoreboard right, because it should be 1-1 now.
We are in the next match. Gwen.
Yep.
Do you need me to do introductions again?
Go for it.
All right, spawning in the bottom right-hand corner of the map as the orange Protoss bringing it to an ace match. But will he be able to win this final game? We have Real and his opponent in the top left-hand corner of the map. The underdog in this group, will he be able to make his first victory of the day? We'll have to find out now. It is Death Angel.
It certainly is. And, I mean, like you said, it's kind of hard to take that fourth fist base as Zerg on this map. And let's talk a little bit about why. So, I mean, obviously, the natural is super easy to hold. And when I say super easy to hold, I mean, like, you know, there's, like, a nice ramp up into it. There's these destructible rocks at the back, but the destructible rocks at the back actually lead straight to your third. And so if we just take a look at the, like, the three standard bases Zerg is going to take here at the top, where does Zerg really have to worry about the Protoss army? Well, I mean, the optimal place to engage Protoss is going to be somewhere in the middle of the map, so that you have time to do that remax before they actually get up there. But there's the side path through the right-hand side. You can come in and flank from the left as well, so it's kind of a map where there's some open space in the middle. You can get a lot of good surrounds if you're really cognizant about where the Protoss army is and where you're positioning your stuff. On the Protoss side of things, though, this is kind of like, this is a really good map for two base all-ins, because you can kind of skimp on defense a lot because it's such an easy natural hold, and then just do these really strong linear pushes up the map into the Zerg. But where it gets hard, and what we talked about a little bit, Zoya, is that once you get on those three bases, like, if you're the Zerg player and you try and take that fourth or here, either of those positions, it's pretty easy for Protoss to kind of control the middle of the map with a big Death Ball army and just sort of, like, waltz off and snipe those expansions alternately.
Yeah, and this rush distance is actually really small.
Yeah.
This is another one of those deceptive maps. Nice getting that hatch down.
Yeah, sneaking
this,
it down.
This base is actually really relatively short rush distance, especially since there's no up and downs, nothing you really need to worry about, just a straight walk here and there. It's going to be interesting. Both players opening very standard, and nothing crazy going on. Gwyn, I mean, this is...
It's normal stuff, man. Normal stuff.
Normal
I will say, I mean, Protoss, the Nexus is going to finish before the hatchery. So, I mean, that's not where Death Angel wants to be. You know, he wants, of course, to have his hatchery finish up before the Nexus, but he's got Lings out at the normal time. He's sending, actually, two drones out? I don't know why he's doing that. One of them should be headed toward the third, unless he's planning on two-base all-inning. But he has not taken that third yet.
We'll have to see what his plan is. I'm really bad at all-ins as Zerg. I found that out yesterday when I did a show match.
Oh, did you? Who'd you play your show match against?
It was against Jorthas. He's one of the play viewers.
Oh, okay. Did you win?
It was the best. No, I lost 2-3.
Zoya, how do you... Why'd you lose?
Well, the first game I lost, I did double proxy hatch.
Oh, my
and it
goodness.
Failed. And then the second game I lost, I forgot why. Oh, it was to DTs, and I wasn't ready for them. And the final game I lost, I did some all-in that I've never tried before, and I didn't do it right.
Gotta do the all-ins right, man.
Yeah, they're very important. If you don't do them right, they don't work, but...
Yep,
yeah, we do have the third base finally going down here for Death Angel. And what are your thoughts on these other groups, man? Which one are you also looking forward to? Because this one, of course, is very deathy, but
are
there any of these other groups that you look at and go, I can't wait to cast those?
I'm kind of excited about Group C with Golden in it. Golden, I would say, like, Golden is probably my pick to win this, the whole event. I don't know. Like, Sleep is really good, and I mean obviously Sleep took out Golden in ZVZ's at Rundown or at Gigabyte Esports Land. But I don't know, I still feel like Golden might have it this time. I think he's gonna come back with vengeance.
Golden, very good. He's obviously one of my favorite players just from the reaction I said when you said him, but yeah, we do have a Stargate going down here from Real.
Yeah, and I want to talk a little bit about this. So, the Stargate on this map is something I like quite a bit. There's a ton of airspace behind the third base here. And I'm actually getting a drone with that Zealot. So, good pick there. But There's a ton of airspace behind that third base. And additionally, there's these rocks here, Zoya. And so